Hello and thanks for watching this video. It is no longer a secret for anyone. Security is a major issue for all companies, and of course the management of TLS certificate is one of these issues. However, certificate requests are rarely automated and certificate renewal still requires contacting the team in charge of the PKI to generate them. This usually means the certificate is issued with a very long validity period, as you don't want to ask for a new certificate often. And this turns out to be really bad security practice. The problem is that this is no longer sustainable in a cloud environment, which by definition is extremely volatile, and also with a zero trust network. And this is exacerbated even more in container environment. Citrix Cloud Native Stack with Citrix Controller can enable seamless certificate handling. It works seamlessly with Kubernetes to dynamically watch for changes in certificates for a given application and automatically configures the proxy which is responsible for delivering application to end user. We have validated this integration with popular cert issuers like Vault and LetEnscrypt. As explained, we want to build a common and automated workflow to allow creation and lifecycle management of TLS certificate in Kubernetes environment and for all applications that are exposed to outside world. We will see how to automate the creation and management of lifecycle of TLS certificate in Kubernetes environment with HashiCorp Vault and its PKI secret engine, as well as the cert manager. I have already deployed a Vault server, which will act as root PKI and intermediate PKI, and will also provide API endpoints for issuing certificate. I have also deployed and configured Cert Manager, which is a certificate controller manager, and it is integrated with Vault. I have also deployed some application, Citrix Cloud Native Stack, which comprises of Ingress Controller and ADC of your choice. If you decide to have ADC inside the cluster, we have CPX, and if it is outside, you could use the virtual form factor VPX or a hardware appliance like MPX, which can be used for SSL offload. Let's look into the flow of how this works in details, right? So the certificate manager checks if a change occurs at the certificate object level, and will use the information provided and send a request to the issuer, which is Vault in this case, which is supporting the root and intermediate PKI. Before giving the signed certificate, Vault will validate the identity and permission of cert manager issuer through Kubernetes authentication methods. As soon as the identity is validated, Vault will create and deliver a specific certificate signed by the intermediate CA. Finally, the cert manager will store the certificate as Kubernetes secrets in the etcd and will renew as needed in regards of the lifetime of the certificate. Citrix Ingress Controller, which is watching the etcd and API server, picks the new secret which has been configured and automatically updates the certificate of ADC which is serving in the application. Let me orient you to my demo environment. See, I have three node clusters, which is running, and then also I have an application running called as Cord. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in my namespace Cord. I already have an application running, and then on the right over here is actually this black terminal is Citrix VPX. And what I'm doing here is, as and when I deploy this application Ingress, you will see, you know, the API calls going to this VPX, and all I'm doing is watching for those API call over here. Specifically, I am interested in the certificate. Whenever there is a new certificate generated or installed, I want to see it real time in my ADC. So let me go ahead and create the Ingress object. So before I create an Ingress object, let me just show you quickly what my certificate looks like. So my certificate name is card example, and then I have kept it a duration for 1 minute, and I'm going to renew it 59 before it's before it expires. What it means that I'm going to have this certificate renewal happen every minute based on this configuration. And this makes up for a good demo where I can show you real time. And then I'm gonna show you the ingress object, what I have. So ingress object, which I'm gonna create, I have not yet created. So I'm just gonna say that I'm gonna use TLS, it's gonna host card.example.com, and I'm gonna pick automatically the secret from this secret name called as card example TLS, okay? So let me go ahead and apply the ingress. So as you can see, as soon as I applied this ingress object, I could see some SSL servers being bound. Let me just show you closely, and looks like there is a new certificate which was attached, which we got from Vault. So let's go ahead and try and access that application. So as you can see, I'm gonna inspect this one from the certificate. So as you can see, the certificate says now it expires at 6 o'clock, which is an hour from now. This is 5 o'clock today in the evening, so it's 6 o'clock. And I'm just gonna agree to this. Yeah, let's go ahead and access it. So as you can see, I have it here. Now I can successfully look at the application. So now let me go back to the terminal. So as you can see here, I have a bunch of comments coming along. So we'll wait for the next renewal of the certificate, which would happen in a minute's time, right? So let's just wait here. And you should see the new certificate show up as soon as I see. Okay, there you go. That's a new certificate which gets renewed every minute. There's a new certificate over here. Let me go back to the application. If you remember the certificate, this was supposed to expire at 6:26. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to refresh this page. Okay, so there you go. It looks like there is a new certificate. I'm going to go take a look, and I'm going to do a view certificate. If you remember, it was expiring at 6. Now it is 6:01. And then what you saw over here is the automatic certificate being handled by Citrix ADC, and you saw that the Vault gave you the new certificate, and we were able to keep up dynamically with the changes in the certificate. That's all. Thank you.